child comes to this world, birthday. Then they don't have cancer. And then they develop their tissues and they are young individuals and they are healthy and they don't have cancer cells. Where does this cancer cell come from? Did you ever think about this? What is the reason that healthy cells, they switch to cancerous, they change so significantly, and then you have cancer? Why do they get autonomous? And what is the reason? Did your oncologist ever talk to you about this? No. There are epigenetic influences. Influences which change the gene good of your cells. And these are toxic phenomena. These are bacterial toxins. These are oxidative influences, and so on. And it is also hyperacidity, lactate hyperacidity, hyperproteinization, disturbance foci and teeth, geopathic load, electromagnetic load. Or are you talking all the time on your mobile phone? Only, by the way, are you one of these mobile phone people? Did you know that this increases the chance to get glioblastoma significantly? Why? Because it irradiates all the time your brain with cancerogenous radiation. So these are influences which you have to think of. But if you have cancer, you have to remove these influences so that not all the time this cancer cell production gets continued. It's not a genetic problem. Therefore, I was so shocked when I heard that there was this actress who removed her breast only because she has the gene BRCA positive. This is crazy. This is nothing else than the influence of our industry, which wants every lady to make the test or which wants to make the operations. But it's not the right access. We do this test on our patients also, and we have many patients with this test positive, the cancer gene. But then it just means you have to do more intensive work that this gene, which is weak, does not express in the body. Why do these patients only get their cancer when they are 50 or 40 or 30? Why not as young children? They had the gene already then. Because the epigenetic influences, they were making the gene active. Therefore, you have to remove the epigenetic influences. And this gene is not only a breast cancer gene. No, it's a cancer tendency gene. I think you should also cut off your head because you could get brain cancer. It's the best prevention against brain cancer. This is cynic, I know. I'm not a cynic person, not at all, but please stay reasonable. Consult with your patients about what is really the cause for cancer and how you can influence this. And you can influence by changing the diet, by changing your lifestyle, perhaps even by changing your mindset.